morning, friends. I actually woke up 45 minutes ago because I had a meeting, and then I also had to make a quick call, which I'll talk about in a little bit because I wanted to share this information with you guys, because you guys know I love sharing everything about my life with you in hopes that maybe it'll help a lot of you guys with things that maybe we're also learning at the same time. I feel like we're all like around the same age, so we're all growing and like learning new things. And anytime I learn something new, I always like to share with you guys. And I know you guys, anytime you guys learn something new, you always end up messaging me and helping me out so much. You know, it's a team effort here. First and foremost, the boys gotta eat. I'm prepping their food right now. Look at these cute little bowls that I got for them a few weeks ago. They're actually cat bowls, so don't laugh at them. Actually, don't laugh at me for getting them. We split our boys' meals into morning and nighttime. The portions are obviously smaller because instead of getting like, you know, the whole entire meal at once, they're splitting it up. I got these little cat bowls that fit their food perfectly. Their kibble's in here right now. I always put broth, like chicken broth or beef broth, for dogs in here to really soften up the kibble. I don't feed the dogs hard kibble because when you soften it up with water or broth, it makes it easier for them to chew and digest. So that's a really nice tip that I've learned over the years. Aren't these bowls so cute? They have different colors. We have Old Man is green, Casper is blue, and Cooper is yellow. And then Riley George is so big and he gets his favorite bowl. He loves this one over the other one. And then I'm gonna add their topper, which is Fresh Pet. You guys know we love Fresh Pet in this house. I also have different measuring spoons everywhere, so it's like easy to measure. Plus, like if like Michelle's over and she wants to feed them, then I have like a layout of how much the boys eat. I'm a very organized dog mom. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but my dogs are like my children. Like when they go to like daycare or like boarding or something, I have all of their lunches out labeled. I have lunch boxes for them. I'm kind of crazy. Oh my God, I think I'm a crazy dog mom, literally. Look how cute the wreath is. Oh my God, I highly recommend putting one above your stove. I think it's so cute with like a satin bow. And then next, we do vitamins. I just restocked on this, they ran out. Oh, I don't know if you guys know this. If you are dog parents, I hope you know this because it's been all over everyone's phones and TVs and news station. There is a dog illness going around. It is very intense. It is a mystery illness. A lot of vets don't really know too many details about it. It just started happening, I think, within the last few months, but they're treating it as like COVID, but for dogs. So basically the illness is like in the air. So they're suggesting that you keep your dogs home from boarding. They're suggesting that your dogs do not go to an actual groomer that has a bunch of other dogs around. Basically any place like dog parks or boarding, daycare, grooming that has a lot of dogs and like has a lot of dogs like walking around and there's like a lot of traffic going on. They are suggesting to keep your dogs at home because this illness is going through their nasal system. The first sign that your dog might have it is something similar to a kennel cough. If you guys don't know what a kennel cough is, definitely look it up. There's multiple examples of what it could be, what a kennel cough is, but it starts out as a kennel cough and then I think it goes into fatigue, it goes into possibly a fever. There's like a bunch of other symptoms. Definitely look it up, do your own research. And also dogs that have pre-existing conditions, like our Rocky, who is a senior dog, he has a heart murmur. It attacks them even worse because they already have a pre-existing condition. So if your dog has heart conditions or respiratory conditions, whatever it may be, if this illness gets to them, it could possibly be worse. I believe that if they get sick with this, they can also end up having pneumonia, which is crazy, you guys. Like they're gonna be at the vet for days and be on like an oxygen thing. It's just stressing me out just talking about it. Anyways, make sure your dogs are fully updated with their vaccinations, friends. Keep them safe. I believe from my recent up-to-date research from 2 days ago, they said that walks are now okay. They're not gonna get it from like leftover sniffing, which doesn't make sense to me how that's okay, but they're saying walks are okay, but they're still saying avoid dog parks, daycare, boarding, and grooming. That is the up-to-date situation. Old Man's a senior, so he gets an extra vitamin. I just bought more of their Zesty Paw vitamins. This is their 8-in-1 bites. I get these off of Amazon. I don't know where else to get them. I usually just buy them on Amazon, but they're a multivitamin. Hips, joints, heart health, skin health, gut health, immunity, antioxidants, liver health, and performance. And this is the chicken flavor. Rocky's a senior, so he gets kind of his own. And then we also do, this stuff is amazing. It definitely cured Riley when he was having his limping issue during the springtime. This is what it's called. It's called On the Move, and it's a powder, and you basically just put it into the food. I have a spoon here that I always use. This really helps with dogs that are very active, dogs that move around a lot of joint health, muscle health. So we give it to all the boys. But yeah, you guys, I think they have a name for it. I think it's called canine invasive respiratory disease or something. There's like a name for the thing now, which is crazy. And then they also do this. This you can get at Costco. It's this brand right here. Ooh, there you go. Yeah, you can get a whole container of this at Costco. This is basically joint support. Our dogs are very active. They jump on couches, they jump across couches, they jump outside, they're running, they're jumping after balls. Also, Oman is a little older, so we like to, you know, make sure he gets all his vitamins.
Oh my God, did I show you guys how messy the studio has gotten over the last few weeks? I haven't been filming in my studio for mukbangs because I've been filming at like restaurants and stuff. So my studio has become a place for unboxing stuff, a place for gifts that we are giving away for Christmas. It looks crazy, you guys. I need to clean this room. I don't know when I'm cleaning this room, but we need to do it soon. Yeah, I don't know when we're cleaning this. Maybe tomorrow. I think tomorrow will be a good cleaning day. Yeah, it looks a little bit wild.
So earlier this morning, I had to hop on the phone. In California, we have this thing called Covered California. If you guys live here, then you know what it is. But basically, it's like a healthcare marketplace that you apply for. They have like multiple locations. If you just type in like Covered California on Google, you'll get the nearest location to you. But they have multiple locations. You can physically walk into a building and get help with healthcare, or you can do it over the phone. The cool thing about them is that it's a healthcare marketplace. If you qualify with your income, they have like an income limit. If you make more than the limit, then you don't qualify for the discounts. But if you make, bless you, baby, if you make under the limit, then you do qualify for healthcare discounts, which is really cool. But I like Covered California because I'm able to go in and they're able to help me basically find what the prices are around for healthcare. Because I don't know if you guys know, I learned this recently too, that healthcare premiums change every year. So a lot of the times they'll go up by like 60, sometimes like $100, I've heard. Personally for me, I used to have HealthNet. HealthNet was my healthcare, and then in 2023, I believe, they upped my premium by like, I think it was like $60. It was a lot. So I went to Covered California. They helped me find a new healthcare. So then all of this year we had Anthem Blue Cross. I think I'm on the gold plan. Yeah, I have gold, which is, I think gold is like under the highest plan or something like that. But I got gold and it was $440 for Anthem. Covered California just sent me a letter that says, hey, for 2024, which is next year, which is like in a month, I cannot believe it, they are upping your premium to $515, which is such a big increase. So I called Covered California this morning to look for new healthcare for next year. And I'm so excited because I was able to get the same benefits with a different healthcare company for $379, you guys. That is a deal. That is literally a deal. I'm so excited about it. And I was like, same benefits, $379, way cheaper than what I originally paid this year. Sign me up. So that is the good news today. I'm very, very excited about it. I am up, people. I am up. As you get older, you realize you appreciate these things a lot more. Like, you know, we're younger, we're like, no one talks about healthcare, no one cares. And then you get in your 30s and you're like, wow, I am really grateful that, you know, we're able to afford healthcare. And since we're self-employed, we have to buy our own healthcare for ourselves. Like, usually when you work for a company, you either get a discount, I believe, or, well, not all the time, huh? I heard some companies don't cover your healthcare, which I think is wild. Yeah, so since we're self-employed, Carlos and I both have to buy our own healthcare. That is the situation. Very excited about it. We also have really good dental health, which I'm excited about that as well. I think our dental health is $40 a person. The coverage is really good. Anyways, I'm probably boring you guys with that story, but I was really excited about my health care. Also, I'm very excited about my skin. The skin is skinning. The lips are not. They are chapped. The skin is definitely skinning right now. Look at this, you guys. Ooh.
I am so upset that I'm late on this, but this is the Rare Beauty Eyebrow Gel. I just bought it last week. It's the Rare Beauty Brow Harmony Gel Lift Tint Sulpo. It is like basically Rare Beauty's brow gel. Oh my goodness, you guys. No one told me it was this good. I mean, yes, a really, really nice girl on TikTok did. It's good, you guys. It's really good. I like that it's a gel formula. Oh my god, my brow hairs look so good. Oh my god. Oh, that is... Oh, I could sit here and do this all day. That is so freaking satisfying. I don't know if you guys can tell. I don't think you can tell. I'm sorry, Benefit. I love yours. This is like the Benefit 24-hour brow setter. I love this. Like, this to me is so good, but that Rare Beauty might be better. Oh my god, just because I really like the gel consistency. But nothing beats my favorite brow pencil though. Don't get it twisted, okay? I think Benefit makes one of the best brow collections ever. This is the Benefit Precisely My Brow Pencil. I've been using this since they came out with this, and I don't remember what year that was. I think it was 2016 or 2017 that they came out with this. I refuse to use anything else. I recently bought this. This is really good too, the Kosas Brow Pop Nano, because I really find brow hair. This is good, but I still keep going back to Benefit. I don't know if this would work for someone with thick brow hair. I have really fine eyebrow hair, so they move really easily. If you have thick brow hair and you have used this, maybe let everyone in the comments know. I probably could sit here and do this every day. My brow hairs look so good with this. And this is my first time using it. This is like a great impression. Wow. The reason that I even bought this is because this girl on TikTok, she uses this and then she uses this NYX Cosmetic brow pen and she'll go in and like make little strokes and she's like the most beautiful brows. So I want to try that another day. But today just use Benefit Precisely and then this. Oh my god, so good.
In the most functional position that it's very
Oh my god, so good. Elf is killing it. Oh my god, our room is so messy. I am going to wear these leggings from Aeropostale's brand. Is it Ari or Ari? I don't know how to pronounce it, but I'm wearing these leggings with some socks and I'm just gonna put on this crew neck here. I'm gonna do this Penn State crew neck today. Oh, I just did my makeup and my hair is in a ponytail and it's a white crew neck. Pudge. There's a trick. If you put like a grocery bag over your face, Carlos is like cringing right now because I have to stretch out my neckline. Someone's at the door. Oh, that wasn't fun. I'm cringing. I get makeup on my... I know, baby, I know. Oh, I hated that feeling. Okay, cute. This is like my favorite crew neck ever. Representing Penn State. We love my home state. Go Pennsylvania. My brother also actually went to Penn State, so... And then I'm going to wear my new UGG. I think these are the micro. I have the mini. Carlos got me the mini last year for Christmas, but these are the micro in chestnut. And they're so, so cute. I've been wanting to wear them. I have to break them in because they're like brand new. Oh, they're so cute. And they're platform, so they make me way taller. And I feel like I'm walking on the moon. Look at them. Aren't they cute, you guys? I am going to choose my perfume. I've been so into this brand. It's called Clean Reserve. I got this pack. I thought this was a good deal, you guys. Yay! We love mini sizes. This is called Clean Reserve. They have, in this pack, it was $35, and I got Sparkling Sugar, Radiant Nectar, Skin, and Rain. And I like this brand because if you love smelling like fresh laundry, like very clean, fresh smells, not fruity at all, just overall, it just reminds me of like fresh laundry. You just smell so clean, so fresh, very like linen kind of vibe. I think you will really like this brand. I got a full size of this. This is their warm cotton. And then I wanted to try these before I committed to a big size. Okay, I wore this yesterday, actually. Maybe it's time that we try. So warm cotton was yesterday. I'm gonna try skin. So their most popular one is called skin. I hope it smells good. Skin, skin, skin. Okay, let's try skin out. Oh good, it's a spray bottle. Oh, that's so good. Oh. I used to have something that smells like this. Warm cotton is good, but I thought it was a little bit too, like a hint of bitterness. Like it was too smoky. You know what I'm talking about? Like too smoky, too woody, too fire pit for me. But skin is good. The thing I've heard is it doesn't last on people, so it lasted on me pretty well, but I like skin way better actually. I'm using this bag today. This is from Coach. Don't know what it's called. I think it's their Pennington or something. I'll link it down below for you guys. I love it because the handle, the strap is really long, so it kind of goes on your shoulders like this. I don't know if you guys can see me, but it goes on your shoulders like this. It's so comfortable. I freaking love it. Let me show you a close up. And it's got their like shiny material. Isn't this pretty? And then the zipper, you actually can put on the side here and you can turn this little knob so it doesn't move, which is nice. I freaking love it. It's so cute. I highly recommend. They have other colors. They have a pink and that green, but I thought black would go with every outfit. Wow, my desk is a mess. I know I was gonna wear my micro UGG boots, but I'm gonna go ahead and wear these because these are also from UGGs. They're the brand new platform UGGs. They're so cute, you guys. Aren't they adorable? Because I realized I didn't spray the protectant spray on my new UGGs yet, and I don't wanna like mess them up. So I'm gonna wear these.
We just got to Goodwill. I wanted to go thrifting today, and I looked up a bunch of different stores around me, and there weren't many, first of all, which I was so sad about. We'll probably have to do this down at like my mom's house in OC because I feel like there's a lot of really good thrifting stores around there. So we'll have to do that next time we're down there. Goodwill's open today, so I figure I would go into Goodwill, see what they have. I want to look for like home items, specifically vases, but I also wanted to look at like maybe some baskets if they had any, like woven baskets. So we'll see what they have in there. But there was another thrift store down the street that I wanted to go to, but they're actually closed today. So the universe is not in my favor. Yeah, the universe is not in my favor today. I was gonna say flavor, you guys. Oh my goodness, I'm all over the place. But anyways, hopefully Goodwill has good stuff.
It's so pretty outside today. Oh, I hope they have good stuff. Also, very comfortable shoes. Highly recommend.
So sad. I found nothing. The music was extremely loud in there too. Like extremely. Yeah, there's a lot of people walking out because I didn't really find anything, and I don't think anyone found anything in there. Home Decor didn't really have a lot of things. They usually have really good vases and like glass, like plates and bowls, and a lot of baskets, but they didn't have any today. And I also felt like I was getting ripped off because one of the bowls, it had the original price, which was 89 cents. It was like a little Asian bowl, and they marked it up to $5. And I was like, wait a minute. And then do you guys remember that little candle? The little candle's $5. And Goodwill's charging $5.99 or something. So I'm really sad I didn't find anything. I really want to find another thrifting store. The one I really want to go to is closed, unfortunately. I think we should go to... Where should we go to? I think there's a Dollar Tree around here. I'm gonna go to the Dollar Tree for a little bit. I'm so sad. I really wanted to find some really cool items. I think we're gonna have to go thrifting down in OC. I feel like there's more options down there. I am now at the 99 cent store. I haven't been here in a little bit. I came here maybe a few weeks ago before all the Christmas items came out. So we're gonna check out what they have. I think our thrifting moment is over. I'm so sad that one store is not open today because I really wanted to go. They have like really cool crew necks on their Yelp account. And so I wanted to go see all the crew necks because you guys know you can never have enough crew necks. But I think we're gonna have to reschedule the thrifting for another day this month. Like I said, I really have to go down to my mom's. I feel like she has really good stores down there. But we're gonna see what the 99 cent store has. Do not sleep on the Dollar Tree and the 99 cent store, you guys. They have a lot of things for your home, organization. A lot of these 99 cent stores are very big, so they'll have like produce and food. Just make sure you guys look at the expiration date. But I love going to the Dollar Tree and the 99 cent store. My mom used to live by one, and I would go literally every single day and get so many things for college and my room and stuff. It is probably one of my favorite places.
They have a bunch of toys here. They're not 99 cents, but I think they go up to like $8. There's like a bunch of different toys here. And candy and stuff. Oh my gosh. Okay, that little spin thing's going for $13. I miss the days when things in the 99 cent store were actually 99 cents. I don't think this is 99 cents. It's like a family pack of Hershey's Kisses, which are so delicious. Oh my God, what is this? A full-size candy bar? Wait, am I getting bamboozled? Like when I open this up, will it be like a full size or is it like little Reese's penis? Oh my God. Okay, I gotta go. I feel like the Dollar Tree like took over Party City because they have so many things here for parties. This is wild, you guys. Oh my gosh. Last time I was here, they did not have this many things. Like these bubble thingies. Last time I was here, they didn't even have these like crowns. Wow, they have like birthday candles, boba straws today. They didn't have any of this when I was here last time. Look at these party display stands. They're like acrylic and you can put food on them. Disco balls? Wow. As you guys know, Carlos collects pops, Funko Pops. So I saw these Funko Pops for $3 and they're from Squid Games. We're like huge fans of Squid Games. I don't know if you guys are currently watching it, but there's a real life Squid Game competition right now on Netflix and it's so good. There's a new episode that just came out a few days ago. We're waiting for Michelle to come this weekend to watch it. They have Funko Pops for some of the Squid Game characters. I'm not too sure if he wants any of these. I remember this is the girl, right? From the show. They have organizational bins for $3. These are pretty cool. I might have to come back for these after Christmas is over just to organize some of the new ornaments I got. But I don't think I need these right now, but good to know that they have these. They had this last time I was here. They always have like Tupperware and stuff. I like these mason jars. The last time I was here, they had like the actual ball brand and these have like sunflowers and they also are a little bit more square. Last time they're a little bit more round. Oh, these are cute. These jars here. I don't see anything here that's new. My nieces and nephews are gonna freak out over this. It's a giant size candy cane and it's actually real. It's edible. Oh, there's a red one in the back. Oh my gosh, look you guys. It's literally a giant size candy cane. I think I'm gonna get it. This is cute. Oh, they have giant gummy bears, giant lollipops. What do I do? Oh my God, this is so dope. This is so cool. Look, they have giant squirrely lollipops down there. Wait, I love this. Oh my gosh. Okay, I can't choose. This would be so cool though. These would be so cool in the gift baskets too. Okay, I'll think about it. I'm gonna grab a Dawn mini dishwashing liquid because we have the big containers and I want a little one so I can just keep refilling it. Okay, we have one thing so far. I just went into the Christmas section and I didn't find anything. I'm so sad. There was nothing there that was like super cute. Somehow ended up in the laundry section.
I used to buy all of my school supplies at the 99 cent store. So I love looking at all their pens. Some of my favorite pens are here. And then they also have things like paper clips. Like these are so cute. They like have like hole punchers now. Never used to be here. Now they have all these stuff. They used to just have like really cool pens and stuff. Now they have like a bunch of different items. But I love going into like the school section. Like everything is so cute.
Everyone's in the Christmas aisle and then it's just me in the school section. But they have like calendars for next year too. I love these to like put on your desk because they're so big, you guys. Like how fun is that? And then they have like a bunch of notebooks, composition notebooks. They have lined notebooks. They even have like college ruled notebooks. When I was growing up, they only had like wide. I prefer college. I like college ruled notebooks way better. Pencil pouches. Such a good place to go back to school shopping or just get any like school supplies. Like this whole thing is like $5. Also, just a fun tip, I get all of my envelopes here because they even have the ones that have the sticker or the tape so you can seal it because I hate licking envelopes. And they have big ones and then they also have little ones. I love getting envelopes here. I just saw a salsa bowl, large salsa bowl for $2. I kind of want this. I love chips and salsa. I think we're gonna get this. Oh my gosh, they have Martinelli's sparkling cider here. I love putting these in the gift baskets for my neighbors and they're 99 cents here. I'm gonna grab them here. Oh my God, what a deal. They also have Carlos's favorite. This is his favorite apple juice, Martinelli's apple juice, also 99 cents. Very cool. What else do they have here? I think Carlos likes that drink, the Clamato tomato cocktail. Oh my gosh. Okay, let's see. I think I'm definitely gonna grab the Martinelli's sparkling cider. I love putting these in gift baskets. baskets with like a bow at the top. They're so cute. I am literally freaking out right now. These are my favorite. Oh my gosh, you guys. This is coconut water and it's by this brand named Taste Nirvana. I first discovered this when I went on a brand trip with Benefit Cosmetics in 2017 to Necker Island, and they have the whole fridge filled with this, and it has become my favorite coconut water. It tastes so real, so authentic. It tastes like real coconut water without all the sugar and like all the extra stuff we don't need. And they're so hard to find, but they're at the dollar. I mean, the 99 cent store. Oh my God, oh my God. I'm freaking out. I have to grab a few. They also have these. Oh, this has aloe vera. No thanks. Oh my God, I'm freaking out. I have to stock up. There's a bunch of hot sauce here, and then also oil. I think we're good on oil at home. Can grab some hot sauce. Carlos likes Valentina. Valentina's right there. Oh, they also have red hot wing sauce here. They also have Asian sauces. Cool. Wonder if they have sriracha. Oh wait, they do. Is this real though? Oh my God, wait, sriracha for $4. I wonder how much it is at an Asian store with the big sizes. Okay, we'll have to double check. Since when does the 99 cent store carry Chin ramen? Oh my gosh, you guys, this is my favorite Korean ramen other than like the veggie noodles by Myeongseum. These are like authentic Korean ramens. The mild and the spicy, they're both here. What in the world? Since when? Ooh, what are these? They also have the carbonara ramen here and the fire noodles.
Consomme.
Consomme.
I hope that's right. Consomme. Okay. Oh my gosh, it smells amazing. I'm gonna have to ask my husband when I get home. I always like to like pronounce things right and not just like brush it off, because I wanna like learn obviously more about everything that I eat. I got the butter cookie milkshake. That's pretty good. Wow, that is full of flavor. They're not bullshitting around.
I am home. We are making salsa. I don't know why I got this like huge craving for chips and salsa, and nothing tastes better than making salsa at home. So I have cilantro here. We have this whole batch for the blender, and then I got extra so I can chop it up and sprinkle it on top. We have garlic, these little garlic pouches, jalapeno peppers, and then we have tomatoes and onion, and then for a little bit more kick, we're gonna do a Thai chili pepper, just one. So I'm going to wash and chop this up, and then we can just blend it. And I'm so excited because you guys saw I found this at the 99 cent store today. They also had mini ones, which now that I'm home, I'm kind of regretting not getting those, because those would be perfect for individual salsa servings. Maybe I'll swing by tomorrow and get it, but I just got this one large one for Carlos and I. Yeah, I'm really regretting the little mini ones. We'll have to go back tomorrow. I chopped up all of my veggies. We have the tomatoes, onions, garlic, peppers. Once this heats up, we will put them on so they get, what's that word, char? Maybe that's gonna happen. What was I thinking?
Good? Mm-hmm. That's really good.
think I made a little too much. It tastes so good, you guys. I went ahead and made extra salsa. I'm going to bring to my neighbor's house. They are still warm. Oh my goodness, okay. So I even packed them little bags of chips in case they don't have chips at home that they can dip in the salsa, or they can eat it with other things like breakfast, eggs, tacos, anything else. I'm going to drop this off at their house real quick. Brand new, still warm, delicious. Should I put this inside the bag? I don't know. Okay, let's try this. It's been so long. Can't tell you the last time that I had this. Hopefully it tastes the same. This is the Taste Nirvana coconut water that I showed you guys earlier when we're at the 99 cent store. I hope it's good because I got 20 cans, okay? I got very excited. Ooh, I remember there were like little bits in it. Best taste by October 12, 2024. We're good. Cheers, friends. Exactly how I remembered. Oh my gosh, you guys. It's so good. I legit cannot drink any other cans that say coconut water because they all taste so fake to me. You can taste the sugar, like the high amount of sugar that they put in. And this one tastes so real. It literally tastes like I'm in Vietnam and we're in the countryside and they just cracked open a coconut for me. Like that's literally what it tastes like. It's so good. If you guys ever see this, Taste Nirvana premium coconut water, please buy it. Sometimes it's in a can, sometimes it's in like a tall glass bottle. Oh my god, it's so good. I'm so happy.
I don't think I got a chance to show you guys this new throw blanket that I got at HomeGoods. I saw it and I was like, oh my goodness, I need it in my life. It is so pretty. It has smiley faces all over it. Don't you guys love this? Like, don't you think this is like a blanket that would be super expensive at Target? I got this at HomeGoods for like $20 and it's huge. It's a king size blanket. It's beige, which I love, and it has smiley faces all over it. It's so cute, you guys. Oh my god, look how big it is. I cannot wait to use this. I have to wash it first, but it is so nice and thick, which I love. Oh my gosh, it's like literally the most beautiful thing ever.
Okay, you guys, this is the mask. Oh my goodness. Okay, I'll link it down below for you guys. I buy mine on Amazon. It's $16 for four. There's a bigger pack. I don't remember how much that is. I'll link it down below because I don't remember, but I know it's $16 for four. So it's a little bit pricey. It's made in Korea. It's a Korean mask. There's Korean on one side and English on the other. And it's a gel mask. So if you have long nails, just be very careful because your nails can go through the mask easily. But you guys, it's so good. I believe you leave it on for 40 minutes. It says remove mask after 20 to 40 minutes. So you can pick and choose. There is a water spot on the lens. Let me get that. There you go. You can pick and choose 20 to 40 minutes. I do 40 minutes and it leaves my skin flawless. So smooth. I feel as if I have no texture. My skin is so clear. It's radiant. It feels amazing. Yeah, I highly recommend. So I just finished washing my face. It says, carefully apply mask on clean, dry skin, avoiding the eye area. So that is what we shall do. Just want to show you guys the mask here. I have long nails. Like, they're not even that long, you guys. I have to be so careful. So this is the mask. It's not a sheet mask that we're used to. It's a gel mask. So the texture is so cool. It's like jello. So it comes in two parts. One is for the top of your face. Like, you see that's the forehead. And this is the bottom. And there is a clear cover to protect the gel. So I'm gonna put it on over here. I'm gonna do my bottom half first. Do you guys see that? It's like a gel formula. Isn't that cool? Oh my God, it feels amazing. I can't really talk loud because of the mask, but I just put these stockings up. Remember the stockings I got at Home Goods? Look how cute it is. I'm gonna keep these on here because I think they're so cute. Isn't that so pretty, friends? These are the stockings that I got at Home Goods last month. I like them. They're so homey. I like the stitching, I like the material, and I love the Santa Claus on there. So cute. I think I'm gonna put fairy lights here. Twinkling lights, but we'll see. They come this weekend. Oh my gosh, I have hair all over my mask. It has been 40 minutes. I'm taking it off. Oh my gosh, it feels so good. Ooh, you guys, it feels amazing. I'm watching the Kardashians right now. And now I'm gonna go in with my skincare routine. Rocky. Hi, oh man. Are you gonna give everyone kisses? Oh, all the boys are in bed right now. I don't know if you guys can see them. Rocky, Casper Cooper, and Riley's right there. I'm sitting in bed. I'm watching the Kardashians, and I'm gonna get some work done, make sure that the video is uploaded for tomorrow, and then answer some emails and just get my life in order. I just cannot believe that this is literally, I keep saying this, but I cannot believe this is the last month of the year. I felt like 2023 just started. How are we in 2024 in a few weeks? It's just, I can't get over you guys. Time is going by so fast. I hope you guys are enjoying Vlogmas so far. I love you so much. I always have so much fun hanging out with you, even if sometimes we do absolutely nothing. I just like spending time with you. And I feel so appreciative that you turn me on your TV and allow me to be a part of your schedule, a part of your routine, a part of your life. But I am feeling pooped. I'm gonna take my vitamin C, watch some TV, get work done, and head, well, I'm already in bed, but head to sleep. As always, oh my God, he farted. You guys, if you want a 100-pound dog, just remember that their farts are like your literally your husband's farts. They're loud and they smell. They're very, very loud. As you guys know, we are hosting giveaways in every single vlog leading up to Christmas. I do this every single Vlogmas. I host a giveaway. So if you guys want to win $100 in this video, make sure you guys follow the directions in the description bar down below. I will put everything down there for you guys. I hope that you guys win the $100. I know a lot of us can use it for groceries, bills, whatever it may be, presents for your kids. You can gift yourself something. Take yourself to get a mani-pedi, my treat. I love you guys so much. If I could give you $1 million, I would, because you guys play such an important part in my life, and I hope you know how much I love you, and I'm feeling pooped. So I will list all the giveaway information down below. I will see you guys back here tomorrow morning with a brand new video. Don't forget to come back tomorrow morning and hang out with me, okay? I'll see you then. Bye!